My name is Kim Workman.
I do gyotaku fish rubbings, and that is a Japanese art that originated about 200 years ago, and it was a way for fishermen to record their catch. So they would catch the fish, put black ink on the fish, press white paper, and get an exact replica so they could take it back to the emperor and show him, oh, this is what I caught, and they would have actual fishing tournaments doing it that way. My late husband was a marine biologist, and he did it for scientific study in college, and I've always painted, and he said, you should do gyotaku, or fish rubbings. I had no idea what that was, but once he introduced me to it, I started to add in a lot of color to the rubbings, which normally you don't. It's traditionally done black ink, white rice paper, and just from there, it's just grown. You know, I've been doing it for 17 years, I guess, now. I'm pretty much self-taught, although I had never used watercolor. I liked it, and, you know, it just worked well for me. So, basically, I just did whatever I thought I liked, the colors. The one back here is was printed in Nova Scotia. It was a 7-pound lobster. So I traveled there and bought it from the fish market. So they steamed it, took it back and printed it, and then ate it for 3 days. It's like huge. Everything I print, I try to eat, of course, except for the bait. That just goes back to be used as bait again. But yes, a lot of people catch their own fish and they'll call me and say, oh, can you print this instead of having it mounted? So people will call me and I'll print the fish and then I'll actually fillet it for them most of the time and return it to them, you know, so they get to eat it and then they get a nice print of their fish. It starts off with the black ink, as you saw, and then I paint the background that it's going to be on. And this was white. If I have the paper already colored, then I will print the black ink onto the colored paper. So most people think it's done in reverse, but it's not. So colored paper, then the black ink process, then I paint over the black ink onto the colored paper. Some of these are collaged, where I actually do the print like this on the white paper, paint the fish, tear it out, then apply it onto the other paper. The one you see up here is actually on metal. I had in my mind I wanted the fish to be like swimming like a wave, so that's metal and it's mounted on wood. And then I take the paper, I adhere it with wheat paste to the prepared metal, then adhere the fish over the metal on top of that, and that's how I get that effect. And the eye is key. Once you paint the eye in, it just brings the whole thing to life. And whether you color the fish in or not, just that eye, you know, it does it. And then when you put a little frame on it, you have a beautiful little piece of art, you know. Octopus is really hard. I've done several octopus, but there's no way to get them flat, you know, the body, and there's a lot of tentacles, and you know, I will do it again, but that's one of the more difficult ones to print, for me anyway. Somebody said my art looks like diving on acid.